we don't have to decide our budget today, but I think we can certainly, let's talk about the four or five issues that we said we could come back to and see what we want to do with those. I have five of them listed, and I'm going to mention all of them, and then we'll pick whichever one we want to start with. The sheriff's request for four new deputies. Ellerslie admin or maintenance person, Ellerslie Park. Sheriff's office, tasers, and we're waiting on word from the sheriff on that. Tax assessor, the person whose position was inadvertently, maybe it wasn't inadvertently, but it was approved and was removed. And then the vehicle maintenance, the
$21,600. Is that the tire thing? Oh, that's 15.
15.5 is the tire balancer. Yeah, 21.6 was both the tire balancer and the heavy duty rolling jack. Those are the five issues that were there. We have roughly found reduced $662,000. So we're a long way from where we want to be, but. Care which one you want to talk about.
I think we need to talk about sheriff's deputies first. I think that's number one.
Okay.
Number one on the list. In my book.
All right. Those deputies, and it was about $195,000 was what we were talking about.
Right.
We had one first shift, and that would also cover the 4,000 was the
That doesn't cover the gasoline.
He doesn't cover the gasoline. He's going to do this. He's going to provide the automobiles just by at least in the first year.
And gasoline is about probably 15,000 per car. My
so that's what happens. You know, again, there's no question they need them. Would like to have them, I guess. It's certainly,
I think they're needed.
It certainly does speak to the thing for the county.
One thing is, it's a total county benefit.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
It's not benefiting a particular department, or it's a total county benefit, I think. And if he had had additional deputies even 5 years ago, but 12 years is a long time.
Basically, the county is, he's asking for a 20% increase, so the county has increased 10%. 45%. The county's population has increased 10.
If we, I know someone suggested 2. It's 4-2 instead of 4. But I do think we need to do something. And yet, and then when I go to the equipment, tasers and all, I know that's still on the table. I just think if my son or daughter were in law enforcement, I would look them have the latest and best equipment.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
That was available to them.
I think the residents of the county as a whole, one of the county, they voiced a lot of the things that we need I said, I don't want any covers to count on four.
No, I thought that for a long time too.
Now, I understand it's four deputies plus supervisory assistants also on the roads, is that correct?
He's got, 44?
Total 48.
Well, then you got one, two, three.
I think you said there were 40 people.
You would have five.
It's probably four.
As per supervisor, not as supervisor.
No, they're not.
Yeah.
Someone had said to me what their supervisors on the road too. If there's an issue.
You wanna look at it from a pragmatic standpoint? If you wanna look from a pragmatic standpoint, we're going to end up changing, increasing mileage. Don't care what you do, that if you don't increase the four deputies, it's not going to make people happy.
Say that again. Say that again.
I'm sorry.
Say that again.
From a pragmatic point, please, if you don't increase four deputies, because you're going to have to increase mileage significantly, it's going to make it that much harder.
Does increase mileage, but you see that they're getting, they don't see that they're getting.
And I don't think that is a reason. That's not a reason. If you're gonna raise my taxes, what am I gonna get for? I wanna see the service.
Your bills paid.
I understand what you're saying.
I don't object to doing it, it's just, we like to pay for it.
Yeah, well, yeah. But Jim, I understand what you're saying, but you also have to look at it from a realist.
Oh, I think you have to do it. I was just trying to give, you know, look at both sides. Someone needs to look at both sides, not just say, well, that's a great thing to do.
I don't think any of us have said it, it's just a great thing to do, I think we all understand. At least I think I do.
So are we gonna add the four deputies then?
Yes.
I think it's a bitter deal, but I think it's just something that we've got.
So we add that. A little over $195,000, $191 something for benefits and salary, and then $4,000 on top of that.
It's actually about $250,000.
$191, $927 was the deputies.
Even that's the other.
$4,000 was the.
You'll have to do with what you can do.
Okay. All right. So that's an A. Okay, tasers, I still, whatever, we've gotta hear back from him on that.
And I think we should ask him. We have put in four deputies, do you have any way to do the tasers and all that additional plus the entire amount?
Okay.
As a trade-off to help us out.
Okay.
So Randy, will you communicate that?
For them, for him to pay for the tasers?
And he.
Out of other funds, he adds control of them.
Yes, for this year and future years.
Yeah. And if he says yes, then do that, if he says no, what do you do?
Well, he owes us an answer on how many tasers.
Yeah.
Question that.
I don't know that he's gonna get back with us, because he said that it was, the others were from the jail, so I don't know that he was gonna get back with us.
I'm sorry, I asked if he knew, I'm glad that he was.
So let's clarify.
Yeah, just clarify.
All right.
But that helped explain why you didn't mention the sheriff's.
Okay. Tax assessor. His position that disappeared, unbeknownst to him.
Leave the room
them, so it'll be easier for us to cut.
I promise you can say anything you like.
It doesn't mean you'll like it.
That's right, absolutely.
That is being added back in as a appraisal one?
Yes, ma'am.
It should not have been removed from the budget, I don't know, say that, it should.
And it does create a hardship on our office, because what we've had to do this past year is everyone's had to step down a notch and do someone else's job. And so that goes all the way up to me. And if you went out here on weekends the last 5 months, you saw my truck sitting out in the parking lot. Just, it was, because that's what I had to do to get the assessment notices out this year, so.
I said we have to put it in, put it on anyway. Somewhere in the budget.
Okay.
So does that mean we have to add in a vehicle for that person?
No, we don't have to add a vehicle for that person.
No, we're okay.
Maybe next year.
So you're adding $46,334.
Yeah, but we're adding the person that I'm here.
Correct. Okay. One other person, and that's the Ellerslie Park.
Recreation.
Recreation person.
Is there any way we could get by as much as said the other night, if we could get by? Some of the time, maybe during certain seasons of the year, with a part-time person. I mean, you go.
I asked John the question yesterday, because he's out today. Do you need somebody there full-time? He flat out said yes. And I said, do you have full-time people at each of your other departments, each of your other parks? He said, yes. So, I know it's a passive park, but you're still gonna have a lot of activity out there.
I have another question.
Just really. I don't know exactly what, but.
What's the status on the sheriff's?
Substation?
Yeah.
There's not one. It's not even being addressed at all, anywhere.
We still have the initial plans for it in a file, but haven't gone out back on bid on it.
But what does the board want what do they want Ellerslie Park to be? Pedro, not Pedro, passive, or maybe not even a park at all?
And I think we're stuck on having a.
Stuck with a good park, I think. Maybe it's not how stuck is not.
Yeah, I know.
It's a good asset. But yeah, I think it's certainly a good thing to have there. I don't think it needs to be paved right now. I understand the need for it, but I do think we could, you know, cut the road, prepare the road, put crushing on or whatever. It'll be a little bit more maintenance to keep that up from. But at least we have it's accessible, and that's one of the big things we're trying to make it available. There are going to be some other expenses for a pavilion, two or three, and we've got the playground donated, so that's.
I think that's only the one for the small kids. We've got two in the SPLOST budget, I think.
Okay, SPLOST is a good way to handle it, I think that's.
For the other playground.
Okay.
I was just wondering, when it comes to the pavilions, until use starts to increase, it seems as though we're going to have assets that deteriorate without being used and enjoyed. If we put it up,
I don't think there are plans right now to construct the pavilions, Brian, are there? It's just the playgrounds. No, not the playgrounds? Yes, the playgrounds.
One giant playground.
Yes.
Which we have a $25,000 donation.
Right.
And two pavilions.
Okay.
We'll be talking about doing one pavilion to start with and then another one later on.
Okay, but that's not on the drawing board on any construction plans or anything we see.
It doesn't have to be. The county's going to build it.
Yes. So.
Jamie's going to do it, so it's basically materials. Randy, what do we have in the budget for the two pavilions? 35 apiece? 30, 45 apiece?
Each pavilion, maybe 50,000 each?
Possibly.
Maybe.
But all that money's already set aside from where we.
No, they're talking about that too.
Oh.
but John Magazine has given me the the information to go out and bid for the two other playgrounds on that park. So you're gonna have a playground for little kids specifically from this money, the $25,000, and then the two larger ones, is what I understand.
One larger.
One larger, okay.
So the $300,000 from the land use, was that gonna be used to pay?
No, we got a $250,000, y'all approved a $250,000 splosh for recreation.
But it wasn't earmarked for paving.
What's the $300,000 needed for the recreation?
The $300,000 was to sell the land that was.
Yeah, what we're using for on the property.
I don't think we specified.
We didn't accept that, but it wasn't set aside for paving either.
Of course, the power person had that, and say the rest.
Brian, do you know why the county happened to have originally acquired the Ridgeway property?
Yeah, we were gonna do a park over there.
They were gonna do a baseball park up there.
But was it used, was it gas funds or anything used for it?
No, I don't know what was used to purchase that property, but it was.
I'll check.
And I don't really understand, except for the fact that it was in District 5, that's the reason the funds that left the ballpark went to this park.
If it's not really needed here, didn't know what flexibility we have with it.
I will check on where the funds came from the initial purchase.
I'll check on that, I mean, if there are ways we could use some of those funds.
And then I'll also provide you when the action was taken to earmark it for this, in case you want to.
You see, how long has that been? About 15 years?
It's been quite a while, yes, ma'am.
Is there a problem with deleting that line item, the $300,000 for this year? If we're not planning on using it?
I would say hire a part-time person out of some of it and give the rest.
And we don't need a. And when do we know that we need a part-time person?
Well, John has said if we, he had somebody there, it would relieve Brian from having to go over there to do what he's doing.
But he's needed now.
Yeah.
But he said that you go over every 3 weeks, so how do you just?
I try to go twice a month with 8 to 10 prisoners.
Right, but if he's over there with prisoners, he's gonna do those day-to-day clearing, that he's only over there every 3 weeks, they can get it done in every day, and get it open faster.
Or part-time, 2.5 days.
Whatever, maybe.
Two and a half full days a week.
Yeah.
That's better than one day of 3 weeks.
Yeah, I don't think it's wise use.
Yeah, that frees Brian up to do.
His other duties.
I just take it home anyway, it doesn't matter.
Yes, it does.
Sorry, it is, still take it home.
Since we cut your person, then that, we need to free him to, free him of the park.
Yeah. All right, so check on the Ridgeway funds, and use some of those to fund the part-time person.
Well, I don't know that we need to swap this with that, and just, I'd say.
Keep the person there.
Let's just keep this.
So you're giving approval for 1/2 of the maintenance tech budget, part-time, which is $19,750.
Yeah, and I think we can revisit it, when the park officially opens.
Yeah.
Then you may need to go full-time.
And are you saying you're.
Although the other side to it is, if you go full-time, now you get the park open sooner, and.
You could actually, I'm just throwing this out there, you could actually wait on this part-time person till we get ready to open the park, because I'm gonna be down there anyway with all the construction going on.
What?
We're doing some erosion and everything else.
What kind of construction?
The buildings, the pavilions, the playground, all that, it's gotta be supervised.
Actually, 1/2 of that, so 1/2 of the year, half of the time employee?
Yes.
Yes, but.
Well, that's true, but I mean, I set it up to where.
Your pavilions that you're talking about, was that the committee recommendation?
That's what's in the plan.
Is that?
I would say probably was.
And I think.
Yeah, it was committee recommended, yes.
I would say it's committee, not the commission.
Plan and commission comes to the commissioners to approve, therefore it's not in the plan to do those things yet.
Well, it was in the budget that he proposed.
I
But the committee.
From the committee recommendation.
The committee actually approved plans, everything, this commission did not.
Right, but the plans only consist of a road and a, circle here and a circle there. That's all the plan.
Right, the same pavilion, two pavilions and two clipper areas.
I think we need to get control back over.
I didn't see a plan except for, there's a road plan and a circle here and a circle there and.
Playgrounds.
Playgrounds and pavilions and.
But this board hasn't seen it to say, yes, this is what they want to see out there and allocate the funds.
I thought they approved the budget.
I thought y'all approved the budget.
I'm pretty sure that the board approved the budget.
If so, we need to see it again.
I think if we said that this is the money that can go towards it.
Yeah, which was $300,000 or $340,000 plus the $250,000.
Okay.
Funds are, you said that $300,000 from SPOSS funds, can that money be invested in personnel?
I don't know. If the SPOSS came out of recreation in general, it may have to be used for recreation.
Right.
And that's where.
It can't go towards salaries.
No, you can't.
SPOSS has to be staffed.
Yeah, that's what I thought. Cannot be. But if you leave that out of the end. But I'll find it there again on Elgin Park as to.
All right.
What was done, what was approved, what's not approved.
Give us a little history on that. I think.
Okay, your last one was your vehicle maintenance.
Okay, then the vehicle maintenance. Heavy duty lift and the tire balancer.
Mark sent out a little bit about the tire balancer, I think.
That's going to be important for more than just cars. I understand the current tire balancer is about worn out, automobiles only. That this new one would be used for heavy equipment, including garbage trucks, ambulances, things like that.
Something that we're currently purchasing from a vendor. I mean, we're having to.
It would have to be, or if not, tires are just being worn out more rapidly. So I think that that is a wise expenditure for that, if it is for the heavy duty vehicles.
So do you need the heavy duty jack to go with it or?
It's just a rolling jack.
It's because of the way they have to lift the vehicles, I think. And they have to have one that they can roll around manually, so.
Wasn't there, the way they were doing it now was very unsafe?
Yes. If I recall.
I mean, that's like a, they basically kind of put one up in the air, they kind of jimmy it around and.
They don't have to be one right now. And when they have to lift a car, they have to pull a vehicle. Brace it and then go around for an hour.
I mean, it needs to be done for safety.
Makes sense.
Okay. Want to put those back in?
All 21-6?
Yep, all 21-6.
So we just added back all five?
Well, I guess we did, other than.
So the taser part, taser question.
Yeah, the taser question, but that's going to be maybe a trade-off. And then the Ridgeway funds may or may not be able to have another source that already exists, so. How you treat it, put it in there. Put in a part-time, part-time is a holder.
I have a question with the way things are set up with Randy. With the Ellerslie Park with $300,000 from Ridgeway Road, is that money just sitting in general fund now? Okay, so by putting it in here, we're taking it out of general fund potentially is what we have to be doing.
Yes, on page 20, there's a notation of that.
Okay.
On page 20, the use of reserves, there's the remaining still land proceeds for Ellerslie Park. So that is in general fund reserves. Page 20, the footnote at the bottom. So that $2.748 million for reserves, general fund, that's how it's earmarked. The donation and old LVIG and current LVIG and I'm rating the Newer Rods Mental Health Fund and the MR Center Fund.
Can we do that?
Yes. Ask the attorney that, he's sure. And if you look at the, speaking of the MR Center and the New Horizons Mental Health, this morning, that the Wells Fargo, it shows the fund balance in those two funds. But both those funds were heavily using those two funds reserves, heavily. Not 100%, but probably 85%, 90%.
What do you mean by using, they pulling them out?
Yes.
I don't know where that went.
For Wells Fargo?
This is where we get payment from lieu of rent.
Yeah.
And it's been set aside, so it'll be covering the repairs and maintenance of those buildings. But according to John, we don't have to use it specifically for those purposes.
So, for example, the MR Center has $85,800.
Left in it?
Yes, $85,800, and it took a lot of years to build that up. And I'm proposing to use $70,000 of it. And then, the other one, the MR Center, has $116,000. I'm proposing to use $100,000. So those two funds will be heavily impacted.
Well, you're planning to heavily impact.
Yes. And then that footnote on page, page 20.
Yeah.
So those are already acquired funds that have been sitting there for years and years and years, and we get money coming in every, so often. Every month, it comes in every month.
So what was the decision on ours first? Half a person from that, or what?
My note is one half employee, one's park open.
What's that?
Once it opens.
And that would help some.
And there's no, I mean, when it opens, with nobody working there, it's not going to ever open.
Well, no, I mean, we would have to.
Yeah.
Somebody full time when it opens.
I'd say part-time all year, so we can get, I mean, somebody needs to be down there clearing.
Clearing trees, cutting grass.
Cutting grass, right now.
Okay.
Cleaning the dock and the house.
So it's part-time, full-time.
And how those hours are scheduled, Randy, would just be up to.
John.
Okay. All right, so that, what does that do to what you now added back?
Okay, so you're at, do you want just to know what your cut number is?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
You've cut $579,597.
With these four things.
That is what you've cut out of the total.
$597, huh?
$579,597.
So we cut half day. We cut almost half.
Takes up all with 83,000, what did you say earlier? Okay.
All right.
So I think on the expense side, that's probably about all we can do at this point in time. Let's look at the revenue side to at least throw some numbers for printouts to come back as to where we stand. And this, what we've been talking about includes the 1.36 COLA, or as a COLA.
Millage,
I'm sorry, millage. So that's already in there. So I guess we need, with these add backs and that millage in there, we need to see, first of all, see where we are, and then determine what we need to do as far as source of those funds.
So does that include the levels of taking from the reserve that you had originally, or does that include the levels of the reserve after I took an $1 million from the solid waste? How much is that taking from solid waste?
Well, it's still at 2.5. Which is more than, and right now it's 4.8.
In reserves.
4.8?
4.8 in usable reserves, unassigned.
Okay.
In solid waste?
Solid waste. It's 4.8 available. And these 2.5 would be taking more than half.
And what are the annual averages of money coming into solid waste? You said?
$1 million profit.
Okay. So we would include bid package.
Things to be decided will be where we pull it from, but also we're gonna need to know what numbers we wanna look at on the employee salary side. And that's, right now we've got, what's the number we're using, one? Two.
2%.
2%.
For the COLA?
And nothing for the longevity?
No.
That .25 is out now?
It's out now.
I think so.
I think so.
I think it has to be out.
Because that .25 costs about $334,000.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think we need to have continued discussions on what we wanna do.
I don't think we can do a raise and that and stuff.
I don't think we can, I mean, we do it, paying for some more of insurance. That's been granted, so that's just for a lot of employees benefit, some agree for that. A few of them benefit more than others. With that, and the 2% as it now stands, I mean, you know, Springsteen said 1.5 was really the consumer price index. So if we move the pay scale ranges by that 1.5, we're keeping track of it. And by going above, whatever we go above that 1.5 is kind of great. On top of it, which begins to give you a little bit more separation. Gives you some.
When do we want to meet?
Millage rate.
After the next week?
Yeah, I think, you know, after.
We've got a schedule right now, 5:00. Oh, we have one, another.
Oh, I had it on my calendar, 5:00.
This past Tuesday was actually the last schedule.
That was the last schedule.
Now, we could do a work session prior to the next meeting to hash out more, but you'll have a public hearing at your next meeting anyway, with what you currently have.
We can cut very much.
No.
What about the 3% across the board? Is that in play anywhere?
Right now it's not. Right now we've got it at 2.
No, he's talking about, you know, obviously.
Oh, the 3% reduction for each department.
That's in here.
That's already in.
Is that in the numbers you talked about?
Reduction for each department.
Okay, so that.
Okay, so that'll come.
How much was that total?
$147,000.
So you add that to your.
And that's 3% reduction for general plant departments only?
Yeah.
No special revenue, no enterprise funds?
No special revenue, no enterprise funds, and not on salaries?
Correct.
Salaries.
Well.
What was that, what the number?
$147,000. And plus, going through here.
What we need you to do is look at each department and see if there is a department that a 3% cut would.
I already did that.
Okay, so those are ones with zeros.
This $147,000, it was like $250,000 originally.
Okay.
And I went through there, I said, no, this won't work, that won't work.
That's good.
So this is the real number, $147,000.
Okay.
That could be in play. But then I'll have to get with every department, so, okay, for example, you know, clerk of spirit court, you know, 2018, where do you want to go? You're in here, boom, done.
Yeah.
So I would, they'll make that call.
That's right.
But it goes from anywhere between $456 up to $20,000.
But it's still 3%.
It's still 3%.
So if it's $20,000, they got.
Like the sheriff's office, $19,000. The prison, $20,000.
But if he picks up that, no, never mind.
See?
I
What's your pleasure? Do you want to try and meet before our next meeting, which is next Tuesday? Or go ahead and have that public hearing, listen to comments and post by, and then meet after that?
It's not, it's pretty short. I mean, it's got, I've got six items on there. We've got a public hearing, a rezoning. It shouldn't take long because it's a basic R1, you know, thing. A few minor, something that's carried over from the meeting, the usual, but it's not real long. After the next meeting?
So we get a public comment.
Same night or next day?
Yeah.
I'd say the same night.
I like.
Oh, I do it that way.
Yeah.
Do it that night?
It's just hard to do, Brandon.
I could, and I couldn't do it Wednesday.
Good night, so have a good afternoon.
We'll have to do it Wednesday night then. Because we'll be at ACCG training.
Thursday and Friday.
Thursday and Friday.
Unless we do it Thursday night.
I'll be here.
Because I have to be in a procedure on Wednesday.
You want to do it before the meeting?
You can do it anytime.
You can do it at 5 o'clock so you can at least do more and listen to the comments and, you know, just make more press.
Okay, so just have a work session at 5.
Okay.
All right.
Did you want to change any numbers at all from the money you're taking out of the other funds yet?
Yeah, I think we probably need a printout of the changes that we've talked about that you put in there.
Right now, the only thing you changed on the funds is you lowered the millage you're taking to 1.36. The rest of it you haven't come from.
Oh, we're, no, because I think then we'll see a new, these things that we said, yeah, we've got to leave those in and put the ones we've got to take it out and then add it back. Let's see where we are.
If somebody wants to get a copy of what we've done, can they do that?
Not until it's done. I mean, if they want to see, we'll have them available at the work session.
Okay.
I mean, we can have something.
If they're going to make, if anybody wants to come and make comments, is what I'm saying, then they'll be making comments on the project.
Make comments on what?
On the proposed.
Oh yeah, but that's all it will be. Because it's something that after it's over, then they get a copy of the final after it's finally done.
Is there any way to put these changes we've had on the website?
And I just keep them.
I'm going to defer to Randy on that one because he's the one handling.
We can, just like the sheet I gave, we can lengthen this.
Except for the changes.
Right. Just we can update this.
Because the proposed budget's already on the website. And if you'll have that as an addendum saying these changes have been made since then.
Or these changes are being proposed.
And at least if anybody asks for what we can direct them to the website.
Yeah, that'd be good.
Which is what I've been doing, so.
That's fine. Yeah, if we can do that.
It just might keep down.
It might, or it may engender some other questions, but at least if it does, it's great. We get better feedback.
So the list I gave you will expand this and fix it all, make it all more inclusive from today's comments and how's that?
Okay. All right. So we will have a 5 o'clock work session on Tuesday.
Yes. Unless y'all change it again.